Hello. This video is for those who want to change from ZBrush to Blender. I also changed my sculpting program from ZBrush to Blender. I search for the equivalent tools in Blender. I usually use in ZBrush. The ZBrush user may want to change ZBrush to Blender. I hope this video will help you to change the process. So this is Blender. Before you navigate in the Blender, you need to change the wagon pen setting like this. Because ZBrush only use left click, and the Blender also use right click and middle mouse, so you need to change like this. I add this Blender here is the Blender software setting, so I change the lower button to middle click and click middle click and upper button to right click. I will begin with the logo navigation. So click here and the logo disappear. So you can, I will show you my shortcut here. You can navigate the Blender by using the middle click in the pen, right, like this, and Control and middle click, so in sort, and Shift and middle click pen view. You can also navigate like ZBrush by changing this preference. See edit, change preference, and go to the input and check this part, emulate 3 button mouse. By alternate way, you can navigate in Blender by pressing Alt and left drag here. It's almost like ZBrush. You don't need to press the middle click button and at the pen. You just hold Alt in the keyboard and left and drag to rotate around, and Control Alt and left pen left clip, that is painted, and change out, and Shift Alt, and you can move like this. It is almost like ZBrush. Different moves at the Blender, and like ZBrush, this is called the object move. You can move, rotate, and scale the whole object as a whole object in this mode. For sculpting in Blender, you don't really need the lighting and camera, so I suggest you delete this like this. And this is the tube default tube. You can add new object here, add mesh UV sphere is the circle. And also other objects you can add mesh. In Blender, you need to change the sculpt move to sculpt the object. You can also automatically change to sculpt move by pressing this sculpting menu. This is the object mode, and you change the sculpt mode. Now you can sculpt in Blender. This is the brush. You can drag out this, and it is the brush. Or you can do by another way. Change this move, sculpting, and it automatically changes to sculpting mode. This mode is a little, this viewport is a little different than the layout, but you can change it manually like this, sculpting like this. This is the move and change to sculpt mode, and you don't need this grid, so you can off you can remove that grid here, you can remove that flow here, and X line position you remove that X line C line here, and you can change this. You can change the material here. This is the solid material. This is the wireframe view. This is the solid material. Don't need the solid material is good for scrubbing. This is for rendering purpose. These two moves are. Yeah. You can change matcat for more scrubbing. Use ZBrush light, so scrubbing, and you can use the matcat here like this, like this, and sometimes you need to show the cavity. Cavity value is so you can see the SN region very clearly, but you please reduce this value to 0.5. It is very harsh, so it will be okay for viewing. This tube and spear has very low poly, so you can cut this. In Blender, you will have you will have two moves, retopo and remesh. Like ZBrush, there is two moves. Remesh is like a dynamesh, and retopo is like sculpting. So I will explain. First, I will explain the sculpting move. That is the retopo. You need to check this part, and this is the retopo move, and press this one to please change this detail size to 4. 12 is very large, it is not suitable for sculpting. ZBrush has one in sculpting moves. ZBrush sculpting moves, the amount of points depends on the brush size. In Blender, you have two moves. These are relative detail is depends on view. This is how far the object away from you and the brush detail. So I will change the brush detail, which is similar to ZBrush. So please check this part, smooth shading, and you can drag like this. You can see the wireframe here. Now the mesh is subdivided according to your brush size. You can change the brush size by pressing F and drag in the brush. You see the brush size increase, the face increase, and the trigger size increase, reduce that draw size, and very small trigger appears. And this is the solid view. In ZBrush, this is the draw brush. It is similar to standard brush in ZBrush. And draw it will add and press Control, and it will subtract. Shift is smooth, so it is equal. It is the same in two program. Shift is smooth. But I suggest you to change the shortcut from Ultra In ZBrush, order is negative, and this in this control is negative. So this thing you must change your habit. Control is negative, and shift is smooth. You can change the shortcut order to the negative, but I suggest you to use the Blender default because order is also used for pupil snapping. So I press order in the mind pen and I press the middle mouse button in the pen and order drag. You can snap view, both top view, front view, left view here, or you can press tit is the button below the escape key. And change the pupil setting. Okay, this is the sculpt mode, and so time to go. Blender has other modes for light sculpting. It is the brush detail depends on your brush size. Blender has other mode like this relative detail, which depends on the distance of this object. If you draw away from the object, you don't need much detail, so it is like this. And you close in and draw, it automatically increase the detail size of the brush. In this relative detail move, brush size doesn't matter. Brush size is not controlling the detail point. Only the distance. View distance is controlling the poly size. So if you zoom out and you draw very small brush, but you will have much higher poly, much larger poly like this. You zoom out and very less. Less poly, you zoom in small poly. So this is like this retopo is like sculpting mode. You can control the how much the point size. You can use this detail size value, but default is 12. In my experience, 4 is convenient for all kinds of sculpting. So another one is remesh. Remesh is like dynamics. Unlike ZBrush, in this Blender, small value is higher polygon. And larger value is the higher polygon. So I check the retopo and change to remesh. So this remesh value is 0.1 meter means you get 10 polys at 1 meter cube is 1 meter cube. So 0.01 means you get 100 poly at a 1 meter cube. So let's see, this is the remesh cube. So I remesh this, and it is 0.01 is like this one. reserve volumes is similar to the ZBrush Dynamics Project shape box. It retains the shape. Faces is like polygrouped. I will show polygroup later. So if you are changing this 2.01 to 0.1 and remesh again, and this is, you see, this is higher, a very low resolution mesh. You can preview the resolution of the mesh by pressing Shift R. So you drag, and this value is here. Okay. 0.003. You can preview the resolution here. Pressing Shift R, and remesh is shortcut is Control R. You can press Control R, and you can remesh. You don't need to go to this button. Okay, I will go to the brush session. So this is the straw brush is like standard brush in ZBrush. This is strength button, strength, this is radius. You can change the radius by pressing F. Strength is also, I think Shift F is strength button, and Shift F is strength shortcut. This is the pressure sensitivity icon. You get the pressure effect by pressing this. If you don't need this pressure effect, you can turn off this button and you don't have pressure effect. So this is the pressure effect. Now you can adjust the radius by also by the this pressure effect. This plus and minus is like ZBrush Z add and Z sub. It's exactly the same. You can get options here, brush option here, like front face only. This is like the brushing mask in ZBrush, and topology masking, and mesh boundary. It is like the topo masking, auto masking in ZBrush. So standard brush is this draw brush is like ZBrush. I used a shortcut to select the brush. You can easily add shortcut to this brush. See, I add number 4 to this shortcut, this brush, by right click and change shortcut, and you can press 4 and you get the shortcut. So I press 4 and this is changed to standard brush, and this is clay street is similar to clay pillar brush in ZBrush. Clay streak in planar, clay streak usually use the pen pressure for radius, but I think it is not approved. It is not useful, so I always turn off this radius by pressure. I use F to change my brush size. You right click and get this menu. This is I always uncheck this, and this mean you can have different radius for different ZBrush. So so if I change this clay pillar brush to radius 82, and I change the draw brush, and it has its own radius value, the default. So I can change this to 20, but I change back to clay pillar brush. It has radius of 82, and it has unit its own strength of 0.6. If you check this on, this brush will, all brush will link together like this. This 56, and I change this to 55. I change by clay strength, and it's also radius 55. So I think and check this one is okay. more convenient for scrubbing, because different brush needs different radius and different strength. I can say I can use different brush with different strength and different radius. The most important brush, all the most important brush are here. This is the clay strip brush, and you need the move brush. Move brush is here, the grab brush. So I'm changing this to number 3 brush. This is like the grab brush is like the move brush. You can see the brush name by dragging. And you can see the brush name. Then other brush, scrub brush. Scrub brush is like the train dynamic brush in ZBrush. I always use the strong one, and this is like the train dynamic brush in ZBrush. Fill brush is like the high polish brush in ZBrush. I always use strong one. This is like the high polish brush. Some brush options are here. This icon shows more brush options. And this in this panel, I change that in the advance. I change this to normal. Use original normal. It's more effective for the fill brush and scrub brush. It gets more effect. So this pinch brush is the same as the pinch brush in ZBrush. Also use the strength to one. It's like that. And stretch, this crease brush is like the standard brush. Sorry, crease brush. It is like the damp standard brush, but you need a little adjustment to get similar effect with the standard brush. So you must change the follow-up to very sharper. I will add the detail and control R, and you get more detail to draw them standard brush. So it is like that, them standard brush. So I get more details, so I will change this to 1005, okay, and the mesh control R. You can see the mesh density here. So press this one and show status. So this mesh is now 1.9 million points. And this is around 1.9 million points. If you run around 1 million, you need to adjust like this to 0.007. So I adjust and remesh again. This around 1 million. So this is that standard brush, and I think this is the most important brush. So you will figure out other brush, so I will continue on the stroke. This is the stroke menu. Also this side menu is more GD, and this panel is like the sub 2 panel in ZBrush. You can select object and add object here. You can change from object to object by changing the object move. Select this one and change to sculpt move, or by changing, and this is now mesh, and this is the sculpt move. I can directly change this sculpt move from this object to this object by pressing Alt+G. And place this, and now I activated this one, and I can draw on this one, and place cursor on this mesh and press Alt+G, and you can change the object here. You also change in here. This is the sculpt move, and this is the sculpt move on this object. Okay, now it is the stroke move. The most important one is lazy brush. And ZBrush, in ZBrush, you use lazy brush to stabilize your stroke. In Blender, it is the stabilized stroke. It is like the lazy brush. So the radius and cutter, you can change the radius and cutter here and this is like the lazy brush. You can change this to it is shorter, it is longer. Okay, you got the idea. And this video is around 30 minutes, so it is long. I will continue other techniques like the stroke method, space dot, and other methods, and masking and clipping and joining, and in another video for this series. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe. It will help me for making more useful video tutorials.